Hi y'all, welcome back to my channel. My name is Shantae Thompson and today we'll be having a little bit of a girl talk, okay? So this video is all about my females. If males are here too and they're interested, then okay, stay tuned. But this is for my females, okay? If you're a female, you must have this question before joining the military. Like, what do I do? Like, how do I do it? Or whatever the case may be. Because I know definitely before I joined, I had questions. I was just like, yo, what's gonna happen? We're gonna talk about being a female in boot camp while having your period and taking a shower. So if you're interested, stay tuned in this video. Number one, having your period in boot camp. It's totally fine, okay? It's cool. You're gonna be okay. You're gonna be fine. Being in a division, right? Like a female division, obviously, and being mixed with like 79, 80, 89 different females, different personalities from all over the world. It's gonna be a little bit tough, but you can get through it, okay? My thing is, it's gonna be a whole lot of different personalities in that room, that compartment. Sometimes the whole division like literally sync up. So when you sync up, it's like, if I have my period today, that means yours might be coming tomorrow. And that's how it works. Literally, that's how it works. But then again, there's some people that, like some females that do not have their period at all in boot camp. Don't be alarmed. You're not pregnant. Because if you were pregnant, they would definitely let you know because they test that and they would pull you from boot camp. So if you don't get your period at all, it's probably because of stress, the new environment. You know, it's just a lot going on and your body's just like, I'm not adjusted to this. So that could be a reason why you don't have your period at all. Or you could be a female that literally have her period right throughout boot camp, literally 2 months straight. And then again, you can be that female that just be regular and just have one or two periods. That is fine. It's completely fine. This is how the body works. It's trying to navigate like, okay, your sleeping schedule is different. Your eating schedule is different. Your, you know, very much your moods is changing and fluctuating and all this stuff. You're angry today. You're happy when you get food and then you're crying tonight and you're getting yelled at and you can't do nothing. It's a lot of hormones and emotions and the body's just trying to figure it out, literally. So having a period, right? When you first go to boot camp, they're gonna tell you to, like, it's mandatory for you to pick up like tampons and pads if you want to. Like, pads is if you want to, but tampons is a necessity. You have to pick up and buy that. They're gonna give you a little card to pay for it or whatever, so you're good. So they're gonna have like in the compartment when you like unpack all your stuff, and this is where y'all gonna stay at for like training and stuff. Y'all gonna have like a locker room in the bathroom. So the RDCs will tell y'all that this locker room is for all the sanitary stuff, like the pads, the tampons, the, what else is kept in there? Like panty sheets and stuff, like panty shields or panty liners. That whole drawer, you can put like shower gel in there and stuff like that, like shampoo, conditioner, shaving cream, shaving razors, all that stuff. Be mindful, it's like 90 females in the compartment. The locker that keeps all the stuff is so big. You buy that stuff and you put it in there because your compartment, like your A and B locker, you probably won't have space for all that stuff. Having your period, right? It's just like, okay, how do I get to change my pad, my tampon, my panty liner? How do I get to do that stuff? What's going on here, right? They don't really have a manual telling you what's happening. You're gonna have a big trash can in the bathroom. It's called Big Bertha, okay? If you get your period, hopefully you don't get it in your sleep or anything and you mess up the sheets, because I don't know how the RDT is gonna deal with that. If you get your period, it's cool. Like, I don't even know how to explain it. Like, you can literally have your period and nobody knows. But at the same, like, that's how much privacy you kind of get in the bathroom, but you kind of don't at the same time. But it's all up to you. Like, it's literally all up to you. You get your period and you literally just go in the bathroom and open the locker. Nobody gives whatever you're doing in there. You could be getting anything. And you grab what you need. And you go to the bathroom and you do what you have to do. And you... Oh, they also have like bags, like they're like, I don't remember what they're called, but they're like literally like sheeted, pretty, they're pretty and colorful, like bags. So you take one of those little bags with you in the bathroom stall and you do what you gotta do and clean yourself up. Put your stuff in the bag, wrap the bag up, and then toss your stuff. There's somebody in the division that has to take the trash out. And nobody really wanna see all of that, you know, in the trash. That's why the bags are there, like the little tiny cute bags. You put your personal stuff in the bag, you wrap it up, and then you throw it away. We're all females. We all get periods, okay? You'll be fine if you're going in the compartment to grab a pad or not. Sometimes you get so acquainted with everybody, it's just like a family, like your sisters, you know? So it's just like Thomas, can you pass me a pad, please? Literally, you're in the your stall and you ask some friend to go grab you something. Or can you pass me a tampon? Oh, what size do you want? A regular. Literally, it's that, you know? So that's that with having a period. Also, if you mess up your underwear, don't be that female to try to cut it up and throw it in the Bertha, because if the RDCs find it and your name is stenciled on that underwear, you're in trouble. It happens. I'm like literally being honest with you. It happens because the underwear is white too. Like, you know what I'm saying? We all know, I don't know about y'all, but like when you're on your period, you don't wear white underwears. Like it just don't add up. You know what I'm saying? I don't know what the procedure is. If you mess up your underwear, I think you just let the RDC know. And if they give you permission, then you can cut it up and stuff. But just don't try to cut it up in the night and then your name is right there and then you get in trouble. So now we're gonna talk about taking a shower while on your period. All right, so this bathroom that we're talking about is not no grand, you know what I'm saying, sweet shower where you have your own little section. No, it's probably two shower areas. So one at the bottom of the bathroom and one at the opposite end. And one is smaller and one is bigger. So one have like one shower head thingy. How can I explain this? I hope I can find the right picture to put so y'all can see it. So it's like a little silver thing in the middle. And then the silver thing probably got like a silver pole. Like imagine the pole was like this big. A silver pole in the middle. And that pole probably got like 8 shower heads like around it. Like one shower head, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. It's gonna be a little bit hard like showering while you're on your period. I would say that while I'm in boot camp, I've never like experienced anybody like having, you know, blood just running on the floor while everybody's showering. I think it's a little bit, no, it's not even a little bit. It's 100% disrespectful to me. It's very unsanitary. It's really nasty. And nobody wanna, you know what I'm saying? Like, ew, ew, that is nasty. This is where the tampons come in play, right? I don't know how to explain it, but it's just like, you just can't have your blood literally splashing on other people. Like, it's not sanitary at all. Be mindful that there's a lot of people in there around you. In the big area of the bathroom, instead of one silver pole, it has 2 silver poles. So it's like literally all female surrounding poles, literally just like that. And people are in there, in and out, in and out, in and out. be careful. People do take your towel sometimes because they think they put it at this place. I don't know what's wrong. It's just like they don't think that they need to check the stencil, like whose name is on it, before they take it up and want to rub it on their body. But it happens, okay? So be mindful of that. I would suggest if you have a really heavy flow and you know blood is going to be everywhere, just make sure that you have a tampon in, holding everything in place while you wash up the goods and get out real quick, because you can't take 10, 15 minute showers. It's literally 5 minutes for everybody, for each group that's going. Like, it's a certain different groups that go at a time. Sometimes we have 20 minutes, like they give us 30 minutes to take showers, right? So we have a 30 minute interval and it's four groups. So each group take 5 minutes. So 5, 10, 15, 20, right? 20, in 20 minutes, everybody have to be done showering, right? And the last 10 minutes, right, to make 30, the last 10 minutes is for the head crew to clean the head, which is the bathroom, to clean the bathroom, and for everybody to get dressed in their N-dubs or whatever uniform and be on the tow line ready at attention. 30 minutes. So you don't really have time to be, you know what I'm saying? So that's what I would recommend. I really hope this video was helpful, because I know when before I joined, I really wanted to know, like, okay, what would it be like? And it wasn't weird. It wasn't hard. It wasn't disgusting as I thought it would be. And yeah, you get more used to everything and you feel more comfortable with your peoples anyways. I would say good luck to you. And also, if you're female and you don't like showing your body and showering with other people, that's totally fine, but you're gonna have to get over it. You have to shower. You have to. And it sucks, you know, because you, it's like, oh my gosh, I'm not used to this. Like, no, I don't want to show my body right now. Like, this is, no. Go in there, hop in the shower, wash what you gotta wash, and get out. Nobody cares. Literally, it sucks to say, but nobody cares. People in my division that literally used to just stay in the corner and just waited until most people were out. It happens. If that's you, then, you know, do what you gotta do, but you still have to take a shower and they're gonna see your body. There is some creeps that will literally stare at you, like, you know, like, okay, like, check you out. And then there's some people that just don't care, like me. Like, I didn't care about who saw what I have, and I also didn't care about what nobody had. I literally just walked in there and I'm in the shower and I'm showering. With that being said, I really hope this video helped you. If you have any other questions, please let me know. Text me, ask me, hit me up, comment down below. People will even respond to you for me, okay? We all go through this. We're all females. And I'm letting you know, it's gonna be okay. I'll see y'all in my next video. Make sure to comment, hit the like button, subscribe, and share this video to a friend that you think might be helpful for them. You know, my females, I got y'all, okay? Text me y'all questions, okay? I'm here for y'all. And I'll see y'all in my next video. Bye, y'all. I need you to-